Assalamu alaikum everyone. My name is Samar Hassan and I'm the founder of Epiphany. And sorry about being late, but I ran late while trying to pick up my parents and bringing them home. So I hope you guys are still around and watching. Today we have two fantastic women on our show. जैसे कि आप लोगों को पता है कि इम्पैक्टिंग लाइव्स मैंने इसलिए शुरू किया था बिकॉज बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जो कि यू नो करियर्स या अपनी लाइव्स लीड करना चाहते हैं वाइल मेकिंग इम्पैक्ट, बट समटाइम्स दे डोंट रियली नो कि किस तरह उस पाथवे पे जाना है. हाउ इज इट दैट दे शुड स्टार्ट क्रिएटिंग इम्पैक्ट, हाउ शुड दे नेविगेट देयर करियर्स एंड पर्सनल लाइव्स एंड रियली ट्राई टू मेक इम्पैक्ट वेयर एवर दे आर, वेदर इट्स एट द पर्सनल लेवल और वेदर इट इज at the professional level. So with me today, I have two fantastic ladies who I'm very, very proud to call my friends as well. One is called Shamim Rajani, and the other one is called Faiza Yusuf. You probably know both of them as the founders of Code Girls. Code Girls kya hai? Separately, ye dono women entrepreneurs kya karti hain? We're going to find out all of that today, you know, in the session. So without much ado, I'm going to add Shamim to the stream and Faiza as well. So assalamu alaikum, ladies. Kaise hain aap dono?
Faiza Yusuf, and I'm a technologist by profession, and I've been working in the tech industry for around 11 years now. And for the past 3-4 years, I've been working on two nonprofits. One is called Women in Tech PK. That's a community-based initiative for women technologists, and another is Coders, which is a coding bootcamp for girls.
All right. Let me ask, Jee, what about you, Shamim? Would you like to tell us about what you do and who you are?
My name is Shamim Rajani, and I run a technology company by the name of Genetic Solutions for the last 16 years, 15 years maybe. And we do a lot of work around open source technologies and four major verticals, which is healthcare, edtech, the concierge industry, and the logistics industry. And we do a lot of work around with customers in the US. So my major customer foothold is the US. Apart from that, I've been associated with some non-for-profit projects around education as well as inclusion. So Code Girls is one of those projects that, Faiza and I founded along with one more partner a couple of years ago. Then I'm also very very much integrated with Women in Tech PK. Then very recently, I am also chairing the diversity committee as well as the skill development committee at Pakistan Software House Association. So yeah, that's a small introduction.
Okay, so ladies, how did you end up in technology in the first place? Faiza, do you want to go first?
I ended up in technology because I fell in love with computers and I decided to go to an engineering university. So my story is very straightforward. I got into NID in Computer Science and Information Technology department, graduated from there, and since then there is no going back. Tech has become, you know, part of who I am.
What about you, Shamim?
So I wasn't in love with computers at all. I was a medical student per se, and tech was my escape because being an opportunist, I didn't have an option to pursue my medical career very early in the age, and then tech was something that came to my rescue, and I picked it up, and I completed my diploma in computer science, and then after that, even after that, having said that, I wasn't going to pursue a career in tech per se. However, that came as an opportunity as well, and I just picked it up, and here I am. So it's been 21 years of not looking back after that.
So 21 years, and Faiza, aapko kitna time ho gaya? 10 plus years, right?
Yeah.
11
years.
Is she counting my age with that?
No. I already know your age, more or less, because of Iram. I'm just being naughty now. But anyway, who's counting age? So tell me something. How did Code Girls come about? Did you guys know each other from before? How did you guys meet? How did the journey of Code Girls start?
Okay, you go. Okay. So Shamim and I both are from Karachi, but we met in Islamabad back in 2015-16. We both were part of...
I think 16 or 17.
So we basically met at a conference in Islamabad, even though we both are from Karachi and we both knew each other from internet, as well as we were part of a program called Women X Pakistan that was run by IBM World Bank. So I was in first cohort, Shamib was in, I think, fourth cohort, I guess. And we met in Islamabad and we got to know each other there. Then we met for a couple of times after that. And then one day when I was in Lahore and Shamim was in the US, she called me and she said, I have some money and we need to train some girls. And can you do that with me? And I said, yes. And that's how Code Girl came into being. Yeah.
Yeah.
Shamim,
so I remember,
do you have another edition? Huh?
No. I have the same. Obviously, we have the same story. But I was in Seattle and one of my very old customers that I'd been working in for a decade. He actually came across one of my interviews that came into publishing actually because of Women in Tech, I think, because Women in Tech was the starting point of everything. Faiza and I met at Women in Tech, not as in person, because I remember when I joined Women in Tech after Women X, and there was this second meetup, and I went and she didn't come. She had, her mother was sick and she didn't come, so we didn't meet, but I met other women, and so we just kept in touch via online, and then we met at a conference in Lahore. So when I was in the US and I got this opportunity, so my customer said that, you know, maine aapka ye phala interview padha tha aur aapne bada struggle kiya, and you know, I want more women like this. And I said, okay, how many? Because obviously I come from a training background as well, 9 years. He had no idea that mera जेनेटिक्स से पहले आई हैड 9 years of you know training under my belt. तो मैंने कहा जी कितनी चाहिए आपको? कहने लगे जी 100. मैंने कहा पैसे हैं आपके पास? कहने लगे जी. मैं कहा जी ठीक है, बस आप रखें फोन, मैं भी आपको बताती हूँ. एंड सो आई न्यू दैट आई कुड हैंडल ऑपरेशंस, आई न्यू दैट आई कुड हैंडल द ट्रेनिंग, बिकॉज वी हैड स्पेस, वी हैड द टीम. व्हाट आई कुड नॉट हैंडल वाज द नेटवर्किंग पार्ट, बिकॉज टू गेट द वर्ड टू यू नो आउटरीच, टू गेट 100 गर्ल्स कम. And to have supporters and sponsors and marketing, Faiza was really good at that. And she was also very keen to do it, because that was one of her things for the next year that she had planned, actually to do it in 2018 or something. That was on her manifesto. Okay, ji, maine 2018 mein ye karna hai. So I called her up and I said, it was March or March something, I think. I called her up and I said, you know, this was on your agenda for the next year. Do you want to do this year? That was the next call I made after I spoke to the customer. And she said, yeah. I said, okay, I need a brochure ASAP. ASAP means tonight. She said, I'm on it. I'm sending it to you. And she sent it. And then that's how we started. And that's how we actually work. We're very, very agile. Hum phone, ek phone call pe, ek email pe, hum kehte hain, chalein ji, ye karna hai, bas theek hai, karna hai. Usi liye Pasha wale tange mujhse. Woh kehte hain, kya masla hai, ye aap raat ko 12-11 baje mein sote hain. Aur that's how we work. That's how we function. That's how now my two committees, Pasha, work as well. So hum bada agile tarike se kaam karte hain.
So us waqt socha tha when you started your career, Shamim, coming back to you, right? When you thought, okay, I want to now pursue a career in technology, and you decided to become an entrepreneur, right? So tell me a little about that journey. And at that point in time, what were your aspirations? What did you want to do? Of course, it's 21 years back. Again, kya us waqt kya socha tha, aur ab kaise, how has that modified?
So I think it's one thing at a time. Mere hisab se, mere liye it was one thing at a time, because 21 years ago, it wasn't being an entrepreneur. It was just whatever I'd learned, and because we wanted to give back to the community, we entrepreneurship wasn't something that I pursued back then. We started training the youth from underprivileged areas of the community in technology at that point. That was 20 years ago, 21 years ago, when Petromen was alive. Us zamane ki main baat kar rahi hu. So we did that for 8 to 9 years, and we trained around, I think, 8,000 students in those 8 to 9 years. And then during that time, Genetic was born again from an incident and an opportunity. I don't know, I've told this story so many times, so many people know it, but it came into being from an email that I received from one of these guys in the UK, Austin. He's still my customer. He sent me an email to build a website, and I said, "Achha, theek hai, bana dete hain, $100 lenge." And he sent it to me, and that's how Genetic was born. And then, you know, so I had no idea that I could be an entrepreneur, or I could start earning from this initiative. And that's how Zentric was born. So I was the first developer, and then I hired a couple of more, and then we basically got our first few projects from Freelancer, and then we built a reputation there on Freelancer. And from that, I think 3 years down the line, we had left freelancing and we were just working directly with customers. And now, alhamdulillah, you know, it's like 15, 16 years that we've been doing this. And mujhe to entrepreneurship ka naam bhi nahi pata tha yaar us waqt, matlab mujhe pata nahi tha hamari हमारी फैमिली में कोई बिजनेस नहीं करता मतलब मेरी अम्मी के साइड पे सो दैट वाज न्यू टू मी माय हस्बैंड्स फैमिली ऑब्वियसली इज प्योर बिजनेस बिजनेस ओरिएंटेड बट माय मदर साइड वाज नोबडी वाज डूइंग एनी स्पेशली टेक्नोलॉजी बिजनेस तो एंड देन सो व्हेन जेंटिक वाज 15 इयर्स ओल्ड देन वी स्टार्टेड टू रिवाइव कंसलनेट अगेन एंड स्टार्टेड गोइंग इनटू ट्रेनिंग एंड देन कोड गर्ल्स वाज वन ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड वी सेड वी वांट टू गिव बैक एंड दैट्स हाउ वी डिड दैट
व्हाट अबाउट यू फाइजा आपकी साइड पे क्या था How did it, you know, did you think about it? Women in tech came first or your other work came first?
So I started my career with how usually engineering graduates start their career, working in a job. And then I started consulting while I was doing a job and I kind of set up a consulting business. So back in 2014, I was working in a company full time. And then I was also doing consulting. And at that time, IBA advertised WomenX program. And a friend of mine, I was on my way to Lahore. Weirdly, Lahore has been very lucky for me in that area, even though I'm not a fan of the city. So yeah, he sent me a text and he said that this is a program and I think you should learn from it because you have tech education, but you don't know anything about business and you want to get into that. So I applied for that. I got accepted. And that program was kind of a pivotal time for me because before that program, I never worked with women. I was working in mostly tech companies where I was usually the only woman or the only woman in the tech team. I did not work with a lot of women or studied with a lot of women in that aspect. So that program kind of turned my point of view of how women can band together and build things together and work together and build a community. And from that, the idea came to build a community where we can connect younger women in tech with senior women in tech so that they can find role models. And we started Women in Tech. So Women in Tech PK was loosely based on the program that I was part of. And my consulting business again flourished because I started getting to know a lot of people. A lot of people started getting to know me. And I found a lot of work opportunities because of the community, because people got to know who I was and the kind of work that I was doing. So even though the idea was not to sell my services or anything like that, but that became like a byproduct of the work that we have been doing. Yeah.
So tell me something. So
I think to add to that, always when you have an initiative and when you want to add value, it always comes back to you as a byproduct, always. So one of the things that I talk about my business itself is that hamara koi marketing department nahi hai. So whenever we get a project, we want to finish it and make sure that it's successful for the customer at the end. Because usse ye hota hai ki when it's successful for the customer will always remain with you and will bring more customers. One of my biggest marketing is through referral, right? And I think that's the best way.
Okay, but let's talk a little bit about the impact that you've had, right? So let's talk a little bit. Code girls ki bhi baat karte hain, but pehle independently baat kar lete hain. So Shamim, considering obviously you've been doing this for a lot longer and you mentioned how many people were trained. So now if I was to ask you, you know, some of it may be direct impact, some of it may be indirect impact. What would you say are some of your biggest, you know, things that make you the proudest, things that you actually, you know, count as your accomplishments?
So I think that, again, Code Girls is a byproduct of what we used to do back then. And because the reason that I was able to pick up Code Girls at a phone call's notice and be so confident about it is because I knew that I could do it and that I had done it for 9 years, maybe 15 years ago, but I had done it for 9 years straight. So I knew that I could do it. Now, again, jab aap impact ki baat karte, sabse bada impact जो मेरा उस 9 साल की ट्रेनिंग का जहाँ पे हमने अंडर प्रिविलेज्ड को ट्रेन किया सबसे बड़ा बाई प्रोडक्ट वॉज जेनेटिक एक्चुअली इट केम आउट ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन सो इवन दो आई वॉज द फर्स्ट डेवलपर द टीम दैट आई हायर्ड वॉज फ्रॉम दीज पीपल ओनली सो पीपल दैट वी हैड ट्रेन्ड बिकेम माई बिगेस्ट you know, my strongest teammates, my strongest colleagues, and even a few of them are with me right now, and Faiza knows their names, and those are people who have stayed with me ever since the time of ConsulNet, and they're my cream. You know, I rely on them. आपको होता है ना कि आपकी टॉप मैनेजमेंट होती है, उसको आप कहते हैं कि नहीं हिलेगी, बाकी सब हिल जाएंगे. सो ऐसे बहुत सारे लोग हैं मेरी टीम में अभी भी जो वहां से आए. प्लस ये कि देर आर सो मेनी पीपल दैट व्हेन वी मूव आउट इन द सिटी एंड वी रोम अराउंड, वी गो टू बैंक्स, वी गो टू इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड वी सी देम प्लेस्ड. ये वो बच्चे हैं जो रोड पे होते थे, और वो हम जब उनको देखते हैं इंस्टीट्यूशंस में, इट मेक्स अस सो प्राउड. One of the other things that really makes us proud is, and I keep, the reason we keep, you know, battling with institutions and academia and other software houses, ki yaar ye degree wali cheez ko aap site pe karein. Jo hai, wo occasional training, technology is one of the, you know, training up. Yeah. Uska reason ye hai ki humne apne bellboys ko, apne peons ko, developers banaya hai. So they... We've done two, and the third is in the making, by the way. Faiza Tahir is doing IT right now, and he's taking care of everything in IT at Genetics. So he's in the making. So we have, and we've seen them grow. So, you know, people who can't expect that their whole life will go up to 25,000, when they start earning 50,000, 60,000, 70,000, 1,000,000, you have no idea the impact that you are making. So I think these are some of the biggest impacts. First of all, matlab alhamdulillah my own company came out of it. Koi irada nahi tha, kuch karna nahi tha, but you know, one step at a time, and it happened. And being an opportunist, maine kaha theek hai, ho raha, let's pick it up and let's work on that. So that happened, and you know, today it is one of the biggest things for my dad and me, because it keeps my dad so busy. It is because alhamdulillah after his retirement he wouldn't have anything else to do. Now that he is the CEO of the company, he basically takes care of everything from accounts to taxation and everything, and it keeps him busy and it keeps him moving. Aur unka office bhi maine second floor pe banaya hai. The reason being ki main chahta hu ki wo do maale chadhe aur do maale utre taki wo active rahe. Not that but I wanted to do that, and he's alhamdulillah happy and party, and I think that is because of Genetic and because of the good work that we're doing today.
Faiza, what about you? Let's come over to you, right? So if you were to gauge some of the impact or talk about it a little bit, so what do you think?
I think my work has been mostly related to working in academia, because I have been working as a visiting professor before CodeGirls. I worked as a visiting professor for 3-4 years, and in that time I can now see my students everywhere. So the company that I was recently working with, I had 3 of my students in my team, and then the clients that I was working with, I had 2 of my students there. So now I can, because I've taught like a lot of people, so I can see them everywhere, and that's like a very happy feeling to see that your students are there and they are doing well in their careers and they are getting opportunities. And then when it comes to women in tech, I think the way I see people engaging in the community and the way that it has given them the ability to talk and discuss and find opportunities and find peers, and when you see them getting back to you with a story that is heartwarming and the story about success, that's really wonderful to know. So recently I got to know about someone who found a client via Women in Tech PK, and she told me that she was able to pay her fee for the university, and she studies in a private university. It's a very expensive university. So she said that I was able to make enough money that I paid my own fee for the semester. And I was really, really happy to know that the community has given that safe place and a place for opportunity, and a place that is clutter free, a place that is clean, a place that is very direct and very intentional, so that people can find things that matter to them. Yeah.
Okay. Another question. Tell us about Crypto Chicks. What is Crypto Chicks all about?
Shamim, go ahead.
Okay. So, I think one of the opportunities that I got out of the Women in Tech platform, like Faiza said, you know, it's for mentorship and everything. So one of the things that I got out of it is I won a program in blockchain training in Palo Alto, in 2017. So I went to Draper. So I was already going to the US, and then this opportunity came up. So I went there and I did my 4 days training, executive training in blockchain. That is where I met this this team. They were a speaker from CryptoChicks. So we met Elena and her gang. And they were basically conducting training on blockchain in other countries, like I think somewhere in Africa and Mexico and stuff like that. And I reached out to her and I said, why don't you bring this to Pakistan? And she said, absolutely, we would love to do it. And that's how then I spoke to Faiza about it. And then when I came to Pakistan, we brought that training for 100 girls. And they were very insistent to bring it for girls in Pakistan. Pakistan mein hume jo hai ladke reach out kar rahe the, wo kehte madam hamara kya kasoor hai ki aap ye sab kuch jo hai sirf inke liye kar rahi hain. So we basically reached out to them and we said ki aap usko 50-50 karein. She said, okay, as long as it's 50% girls, let's do this. So we it was a training with in collaboration with Blog Geeks. जिसमें उनकी ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग थी 3 महीने की, वो हम लेकर आए पाकिस्तान. उसके बाद उन्होंने हैकाथॉन कंडक्ट करवाया, व्हिच वाज अ 3-डे हैकाथॉन. वो हमने किया. अब उनका सेकंड राउंड चल रहा है ट्रेनिंग्स का. सो चूंकि ड्यू टू कोविड थोड़ा सा पेस आउट हो गया है, लेकिन ये कि वो चल रहा है, होपफुली दैट इज गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू. ऑल्सो सिंस ब्लॉकचेन हैज स्लाइटली टेकन अ बैक सीट, स्लाइटली नॉट दैट मच, 2016 में बहुत एक्टिव था, तो इसलिए भी थोड़ा सा हम भी थोड़ा सा बैक स्टेप पे चले गए, लेकिन इट्स स्टिल ऑन गोइंग. सो इट्स बेसिकली ऑल अबाउट ब्लॉकचेन ट्रेनिंग एंड लर्निंग अबाउट द न्यू टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड द डिसरप्टिव इकोसिस्टम.
अच्छा, मुझे ये बताएं, व्हाट अबाउट कोड गर्ल्स? सो हाउ मेनी वुमेन हैव नाउ बीन ट्रेन्ड एंड हाउ मेनी हैव देम ऑफ देम हैव गॉटन एम्प्लॉयड और फ्यूचर प्लान्स? तीन चीजें, राइट? सो क्या इंपैक्ट टुडे?
आई विल फाइजर टॉक अबाउट द इंपैक्ट एंड देन आई विल टॉक अबाउट द फ्यूचर प्लान.
Okay, so we have nearly 500 graduates from the program, and around 100 of them have been placed in the industry on paid internships and jobs, both on site and remote. And we are, because of COVID, we have kind of lessened in the middle of that, like from March till the last few months, we were off because of COVID, and we did like small classes online. But the program is mainly on site, so we wanted to kind of restart it with less number of students so that we can maintain social distancing and everything. So we have again inducted a smaller batch for phase one, and I had my workshop with them today. So so yeah, this is what has been happening. And when it comes to impact, what we are seeing in terms of, not just in terms of them getting employed, getting opportunities in tech, but also like their ability to be confident about their capabilities and skills. So today when in workshop and I was talking to these girls and they were telling me about their interest, and you can see that it's not for us, it's important that they get employed. For us, it's important that they join tech because that's the whole plan. But still, if they have other things that they really are passionate about and tech can help them enabling, you know, there and become like an aid at that path, that would also be lovely. We are seeing a lot of mothers in the program. We are seeing a lot of married women in the program who are joining the program because they want to add to the family income, because they want to work and get their children to better schools, get their families to, you know, make better money. So that's again, that wasn't something that was intended. We did not intend it to be a program mainly for married women. The program was for everyone, but when the data started coming in, we realized that around 40% of these women were married, and almost all of them had children. So that was, again, that was wonderful. We also saw a lot of them were coming to the program because they were not looking for full-time employment, but rather looking for ways in which they can teach their children about tech. They wanted to learn about tech because a lot of them wanted to be you know, empowered enough to use tech with confidence. So these are the things that we are seeing, again, byproducts of the actual plan that we had, and really happy about it.
Jee, Shamim, you wanted to add something to it.
So I'm just going to talk about future plans, but before that, a couple of things. Just adding to what Faiza was saying, humne 500 ladkiyan zarur train kiye, lekin usme se, so kyunki phase 1 aur phase 2 dono ko count kar rahe hote hain, but usually phase 1 ki ladkiyan hi phase 2 mein ja rahi hoti hain. तो और लड़कियों को नॉर्मली जॉब उस वक्त मिलती है जब वो फेज टू कर लेती हैं, कोई भी एडवांस ट्रैक कर लेती हैं. तो हमारे पास फेज टू में से
दोनों फेजेस कितने लंबे होते हैं? हाउ लॉन्ग इज फेज 1 एंड हाउ लॉन्ग इज
4 मंथ्स? ईच फेज इज 4 मंथ्स. सो यूजुअली गर्ल्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ फेज 1 go to phase two. So from phase one, they do HTML, CSS and JavaScript or jQuery. Mm-hmm. And then they go to phase two. Wahan pe wo kisi bhi ek track ko choose karte hain, either WordPress or PHP or Node.js or SQA or UX, user experience, UI, UX design. So usme se jab wo pass out karti hain, to phir unko jobs usually mil jati hain. तो ये तकरीबन 8 महीने की जर्नी होती है. तो हमारा जो फेज टू है, एंड करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग, फादर, अराउंड 200 गर्ल्स आउट ऑफ फेज टू राइट नाउ, ऑलमोस्ट वी हैड थ्री कोहोर्ट्स. तो जो है उसमें से अगर आप समझे कि 200 में से 100 लड़कियों को प्लेसमेंट्स मिलना, आई थिंक दैट्स अ ह्यूज अचीवमेंट. सो अगर आप उसको इस तरीके से देखें तो वो जो है इट्स अ ह्यूज अचीवमेंट कि तकरीबन 50% लड़कियों को प्लेसमेंट्स हो जाते हैं.
व्हाट इज द एवरेज सैलरी लाइक फॉर दीस वुमेन?
द एवरेज सैलरी इज लाइक 25,000 टू स्टार्ट विद, बट वी हैव हैड गर्ल्स हु हैड 10,000 टू 40,000. सो गर्ल्स हैव स्टार्टेड एट 40 एंड गर्ल्स हैव स्टार्टेड एट 10, बट जो एवरेज है वो 25,000 इस वक्त जो उनको मिलती है. उसके बाद जो है वो एंड यू नो कंपनीज लाइक यू नो लाइक्स ऑफ कॉन्टोर, रैपिड कंप्यूट, पाशा, एनीबडी एंड एवरीबडी इज हायरिंग दीस गर्ल्स. अच्छा, दूसरा जो इम्पैक्ट आया है कोविड का, जो विच हैज एक्चुअली पुट अप, अपार्ट फ्रॉम द फैक्ट दैट वी कुड नॉट कंटिन्यू ट्रेनिंग, हमारा जो प्लेसमेंट वाला जो विंग है वो बहुत तेज हो गया. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इन मार्च वी हैड अराउंड 48 प्लेसमेंट्स एंड बाय द एंड ऑफ अक्टूबर वी हैड अराउंड 96 बिकॉज वर्क फ्रॉम होम वाज अ नॉर्म एंड सो दे डिड नॉट हैव अ प्रॉब्लम हायरिंग गर्ल्स. सो वी हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेरीज टू हायर दीस गर्ल्स. सो हमारा जो 100 का मार्क रीच हुआ वो इसीलिए रीच हुआ है कि वर्क फ्रॉम होम बन गया, ठीक है, एंड दे स्टार्टेड हायरिंग. One of the other things that we also have done right in the beginning is we have also, involved our sponsors, global sponsors, and our employers, jo hamare, our customers. So, jo mere customers hain, jo 5G customers hain, because jinko agar dedicated VA hire karna hota hai, dedicated developer hire karna hota hai, and they cannot afford the cost that we are asking for, then we connect them with these girls. So, hamare is 100 mein se takriban 20% aisi ladkiyan hain jo bahar ke saath kaam kar rahi hain. To wo ya to Zurich ke saath कर रही है, दुबई के साथ है, कनाडा के साथ है, यूएस के साथ, उनके साथ काम कर रही ऑलरेडी. सो दैट गेटिंग दैट एक्सपीरियंस एज वेल. सो वन ऑफ आई हैव टू गर्ल्स हु आर वर्किंग विद एन इंजीनियर फ्रॉम एयरबीएनबी आउट ऑफ सिएटल राइट नाउ. तो जो है इस तरह की एक्सपीरियंसेस उनको हो रहे हैं. सो जस्ट वांटेड टू ऐड दैट. उसमें जो हमारा फ्यूचर प्लान है, one of the things that we are also doing is we are, jaise Faiza ne shayad bataya hai, mujhe nahi pata, mujhe yaad nahi hai, lekin one of the things that we also do is we always involve industry experts to help us, to guide us, ke wo is outline ko hum better kis tarike se karte. One of the industry experts that we have actually shown the outline to recently, unhone hume suggest kiya ki ji hum usme Python introduce kare. So one of the things that we are trying to do in the next cohort is we are going to revamp the outline, revamp the syllabus, and include Python as a mandatory, option, mandatory technology stack. कि जो हर एक ने सीखना है, उसके लिए हम अपनी onboarding criteria भी change करें. So something that we keep doing every couple of months, we come back on the table and we fix and we try to keep updated to what the industry requires, because ये बहुत जरूरी है. We cannot forget the problem statement. The problem statement is the industry is unable to find the right fit and we are trying to produce the right fit. So uske liye hum, we go back to the table every few months and we fix our syllabus, we fix the way we are taking this forward to make sure that hum zyada se zyada jo hai matchmaking karwa sake. So two things that we are looking at in 2021 and moving forward, this was the plan for actually 2020, but COVID hit and we couldn't pursue it. Is increase recruitments, to increase placements. But one of the things that Code Girls wants to do is to move into recruitment, diverse recruitment. Okay. So that is one of the things that we are looking at. We are doing our homework on that, and we will probably come out in 2021 with something around that. Not sure what it is. Abhi hame nahi pata. Abhi sab kuch hawa mein hai. So we are still talking about it, and we'll see what it is. Okay. It is definitely on the table. It's been around for a year. दूसरा ये है कि one of the things that I am trying to do and Faiza is trying to do and we want people like you to push as well, is कि हम ये चाह रहे हैं कि अगर हम as an entity, as Genetic as an entity is able to bring long term projects to Pakistan, projects as human to machine learning, projects in SEO, projects in as to hire virtual assistants for website maintenance, projects in BPO, तो हम उन लड़कियों को बल्क में हायर कर सकते हैं, और हम जो है you know, so we can basically create jobs ourselves. So there is also two things that we are looking at it towards in 2021 is recruitment and then bringing long-term low-end projects to Pakistan. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's
the okay thing. What are some of the challenges that you guys faced and how did you guys overcome them? Of course, girl power, wo to thi, but other than that,
Faiza, you want to go on that? Let me tell you. Challenges hain, definitely.
Faiza, kari ab shimi mein bolti ji. Very, very naughty, Faiza. Achha, chalo, let me ask.
There are challenges. Definitely, one of the biggest challenges that we had initially was sponsorships. But as the program proved itself, sponsorships became comparatively comparatively easy. Maybe 2020 mein itna pata nahi chal raha because 2020 mein itni training nahi hui hai, but again towards the end of 2020, if you look at early 2020, in March 2020, I was sort of like very happy because I had basically acquired or brought on board sponsorship for the whole year, and I was like, I'm done, you know. So 2020 ki bootstrapping ho chuki, paise aa chuke, paise matlab commitments aa chuke, theek hai. COVID aa gaya. अब जब ठीक है, अब हम शुरू कर रहे हैं, तो वो जो कमिटमेंट्स थी वो सारी भाग गई. तो ऑब्वियसली दैट्स एन ऑनगोइंग स्ट्रगल. स्पॉन्सरशिप इज एन ऑनगोइंग
स्ट्रगल. सो फॉर आवर ऑडियंस अगेन, ठीक है, जस्ट फॉर द ऑडियंस पर्पस एज वेल, ऑफ कोर्स नॉट एवरीबॉडी यू नो, सो फॉर अ लॉट ऑफ द व्यूअर्स, मे बी आप एक्चुअली ऑन द ग्राउंड काम नहीं कर रहे, बट अनदर वे टू क्रिएट इम्पैक्ट इज टू हेल्प पीपल हु आर ट्राइंग टू डू दैट एंड सपोर्ट देम, वेदर इट इज in the form of donating time or sometimes just donating real hard cash, right? Because that's really, really important. So Shamim, for one person, right, when you have to go through phase one, and suppose she also goes through phase two, what does that approximately cost you?
So for phase one, it costs us around $120 or 20,000 rupees for the 4 months of training. So that's $1 an hour because 125 hours of training hoti hai, to break it. Into hours, or if you want to sponsor a girl for one phase, that's $120. If you want to sponsor a girl for the whole year for three phases, then it's $360. If you want, obviously you can do the math. If you want to sponsor a batch, then obviously you can do the math. However, so sponsorship was one of the things. Dusri jo badi cheez hai jisme humne problem hui thi, wo making the corporate sector or the MNCs understand that degree is not important. Degree is important, but degree should not be the reason to onboard somebody. Should not be a barrier, right? So ye hame shuru mein problem hui thi, but I think humne jab thoda sa apna sar mara to uske baad we were able to get through to a couple of to a good number of MNCs, and hamari bachiyan jo hai wahan pe hire bhi hui hain. So, lekin again, still in Pakistan, the mindset is still a bit conservative compared to, you know, Google, Microsoft, IBM, jahan pe degree does not matter, right? Aap contract pe lete hain bachon ko hamare. There are so many examples of Pakistani kids working in Google on contracts. So that is also another area jahan pe hume problem hoti hai. So when we go out and we ask them to help us hire, to help with sponsorship, and then to help nominate, because we also need the right kind of girls. We reach out is also important, right? So it's not like everybody's walking in, and it's not like you're going to be able to everybody who walks in, and you should not, right? So we have a zero test that we are actually going to sit down and improve on as well right now. So having the right kind of candidates on board is just as important.
जो आपकी टिपिकल जो इनटेक होती है, द काइंड ऑफ पीपल दैट यू रिक्रूट, व्हाट हैव दे स्टडीड, व्हाट इज देयर लेवल? आई नो दैट यू टॉक्ड अबाउट समटाइम्स इट्स मैरिड वुमेन, दैट्स ओके, बट व्हाट हैव इन टर्म्स ऑफ एकेडमिक बैकग्राउंड, व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ बैकग्राउंड डू दे हैव? सोशियो इकोनॉमिक का भी वी अंडरस्टैंड के मार्जिनलाइज्ड होती है,
राइट? सो हमारे पास अभी पोर्टल्स में जितनी भी लड़कियां आती हैं, हम उनके साथ एक प्री असेसमेंट और पोस्ट असेसमेंट कर रहे होते हैं to collect data about who they are and why they are in the program. तो हमने अभी देखा है usually के जो average education है that is intermediate, but we still have girls who have done graduate or even postgraduate degrees, लेकिन usually technology या engineering का background नहीं होता. हमारे पास कुछ ऐसी लड़कियां भी हैं जो कि engineering की student हैं, लेकिन वो यूजुअली ऐसी यूनिवर्सिटीज से पढ़ रही हैं या कोई ऐसे टेक्निकल गवर्नमेंट कॉलेजेस से पढ़ रही हैं जिनका इतना अच्छा अकेडेमिक यू नो उनका ऐसा ट्रैक रिकॉर्ड नहीं है एकेडमिकली. सो वी हैव आल्सो सीन दैट वो लड़कियां हु वर अनेबल टू काइंड ऑफ गेट अ जॉब आफ्टर गेटिंग फ्रॉम अ यूनिवर्सिटी काइंड ऑफ कम टू द प्रोग्राम बिकॉज दैट बिकम्स यू नो अ वे टू गेट इनटू द इंडस्ट्री. दूसरा ये है कि हमारे पास जो एवरेज फैमिली इनकम है दैट इज समवेयर फ्रॉम 25,000 टू 30-40,000 रुपीज अ मंथ ऑफ द हाउस होल्ड. तो जब वो लड़कियां जो है वो प्रोग्राम से ग्रेजुएट होकर इंटर्नशिप या जॉब्स पे लगती हैं तो वो यू नो जो इनफ्लक्स है मनी का दैट ऑल्सो चेंजेस अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फॉर देम. सो ये यूजुअल हमारा प्रोसेस है बट राइट नाउ वी बिकॉज वी हैव डिसाइडेड टू काइंड ऑफ मूव अहेड एंड एड मोर coding to the phase one of the program. So we are redoing the induction process by adding more details to it. So we are looking for better candidates in the sense because even though hamara retention rate is 80%, but still we want to improve it and we want to convert it into more jobs. So that is really, really important here.
Okay, so I know that you were getting distracted because make the questions Dalriti. So a friend of mine has asked me to ask this question off of you guys. Who is your role model? So Shamim, why don't you answer? Acha, you're mute.
So apart from a lot of the people that are, and to be very honest, Faiza is one of them. And I also have a couple of other friends. But if you talk about celebrities, I think Oprah is somebody who really inspires me, Oprah Winfrey. Because of the background that she comes from and where she is today and what she's doing to make an impact. So the biggest message that I take from her is that you don't have to have all the money in the world to make an impact. When you start making an impact, money follows. So and you should always, you know, work towards adding value, and it will bounce back. That's the law of nature. So mm-hmm. So that is why she's one of my biggest role models. Yeah.
जी फैसा बेसाइड शमीम ठीक है ना फैसा इसको कंप्लीमेंट वापस देते हैं
नॉट सेइंग दैट नॉट सेइंग दैट सो आई एम अ पर्सन हु काइंड ऑफ रियली एंजॉयज रीडिंग सो देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ फीमेल ऑथर्स दैट आई वुड से हैव डन अ वंडरफुल जॉब इन टर्म्स ऑफ राइटिंग एंड अ लॉट ऑफ रिसर्चर्स दैट हैव डन अ वंडरफुल जॉब इन टर्म्स ऑफ presenting their research to the world. But recently I've been following a lot of AOC, which is a politician in the US, and kind of seeing her journey become a congresswoman and working her way out against all odds has been really, really inspiring. So I'm usually not an Instagram person, but kind of really follow her there to see her stories and get to know what she's doing. So that's really inspiring. And I think she is the kind of role models that we need. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And ek abhi kyunki, because just a minute back we were talking about some challenges and obstacles and hard steps whenever you're trying to do something which is perhaps difficult at the beginning. Jaise aap bata bhi rahi thi Shamim ki ek dafa jab proof hona shuru hua, when the proof of concept was there, then people want to support it. Yeah, usually yehi hota hai ki when you have already attained success, people actually turn around and want to follow you, right? So that's how you know we're structured. So how do you follow?
They want to get on the bus, not follow.
Free riders bhi hote hain, of course, acha. Lekin still. So both of you, how do you guys cope with failures, obstacles? What do you guys do? What are some strategies?
So मुझे आज बड़ा मजा आया. Faiza ने मुझे जो है वो टैग किया एक ट्वीट पे, and that was actually an eye opener. I could be absolutely wrong here, but one of the things that with women, when they have a woman clan and they have friends, they open up. Women, अगर वो emotional हो जाती हैं, तो वो open up करती हैं, बताती हैं. So whenever we have failures and obstacles, we open up and we tell each other about it. I think that's the biggest way to get it out of your system and move on. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the other biggest thing is to learn from your failures. मैं जब शुरू में when I was doing these conferences when I was young and doing this conference, वो कहते थे जी failure से सीखे. मुझे समझ नहीं आता था कि क्यों कहते हैं कि failure से सीखे. It doesn't make sense. But, you know, 15 years down the line, I understand what they mean, because I think failures teach you so much more than, you know, successes, and you don't make those mistakes again and you get stronger. So I think failure se seekhna bahut zaruri hai, and then I think you should have a channel out. So when you're emotional and when you are, you know, totally up there, you should have a channel out to get it out of your system so that then you can think clearly. So that's one of the things we also tell our girls to do, and they make mistakes. I mean, we expect them to make mistakes. We don't expect them to not make mistakes. Just this morning, I was talking to one of my girls who made a major blunder, and I told her how it is going to impact her and how she can fix it. But then we are there. We hum unke peeche khade hote hain ki theek hai, when they make mistakes and they come back to us, we hum unko daantte bhi hain aur hum unko samjhate bhi hain. Exactly what we do at Women in Tech as well. You know, so we're not always all you know, rosy and buddy and happy about whatever the ladies do there. We kick them out. We kick their asses as well. We kick them out as well. And that's what they don't like us for that. And I'm sorry, I'm using that, but they don't like us for that. Like, in yeah, both important to make them understand that we
absolutely
care.
Overall, you want the positive, absolutely, because there's so many people like you, and everybody's trying to do their own part to create impact, right? And positive energy create karne ki zarurat hai na, taki more and more women, young people, they start exploring themselves and start finding their true potential. Faiza, you were nodding and smiling. What do you do when, you know, when you're getting frustrated or upset, or just you feel like crying because nothing
is
going
on Twitter.
What?
I rant on Twitter. Have you seen my Twitter?
Oh yes, I've noticed a few times. Aajkal main bilkul bhi tweeting nahi kari, sorry. But yes, I have noticed in the past and reached out and said, what's going on? Kya ho gaya? Is everything okay?
Yeah. So I do that. So I tend to do that because that's like my way out, in the sense that I'll send an angry tweet or two and then I'm okay. The reason that Shamim, I wanted to add to what Shamim said in terms of mistakes and failures. So I think in today only we were discussing about getting into something and failing in our workshop. And I think the basic ability to reflect on what you did and how it impacted the outcome is extremely important. Usually we are taught to kind of put failures on circumstances and on other people, so that learning part kind of goes missing, in the sense ki hum kehte hain to is wajah se ho gaya, us wajah se ho gaya, us wajah se ho gaya. Wo jo causation hai uski, if it came from you because of your actions or whatever that is, wo bahut important hai. Aur wo ability to reflect, ability to bounce your ideas off. So a lot of times I'll make a mistake and then I'll text Shamim and ask her ki yaar ye kar diya maine, what do you think about it, and she'll tell me it's good or bad or whatever that is. And you need to have that tribe who's there to kind of show you the mirror, in the sense that when you are acting unreasonable, they can tell you that, you know, you are being unreasonable. So a lot of times I will say something and she'll, you know, put her feet on my tail and say, ye kyun bola hai? Ye kyun bola hai? And that happens. You need people around you that way.
It's not all lovey and dovey all the time.
It's not very tough.
You guys are co-founders, na, in a business. Obviously, co-founders have to fight as well, right? Otherwise, it's not much fun. You have to brainstorm with one another and be like,
We don't fight.
It's going to happen.
And, it's not just about being co-founders. It's about everything. It's about being. I think it's about being there for each other. We watch each other's back, but not in the wrong way, not in that if she's making a mistake and I'm going there and, you know, putting my sleeves up, koi usko haath na lagaye, aise nahi hota. I tell her, you made this, you did this, now go fix it, I'll help you fix it, but you have to accept that you're, and she does the same with me, you know, and we have other friends as well that we do this with. So I think it's very important to learn from your failures, and, you know, like she said, that, you know, reflect back on it and see that kisi pe ungliyan uthane se pehle khud ko dekho ki yaar maine kya kiya, what did I do wrong to make this happen.
And just reflection, and then, like you said, right? I think that's important. Sorry, G. Faiza.
Yeah, and then I think it's also important to kind of forgive yourself if you have made a mistake, because that's the toughest part, because a lot of time we kind of don't. And I think that in a lot of cases, women are usually very hard on themselves when it comes to mistakes, because we are trained in a way that if you have made a mistake, that's a permanent mark on you. In a lot of cases, we have seen that. So I think wo bhi bada zaruri hai, because hum code girls unko yehi sikha rahe hote hain ki acha ye nahi ho raha, matlab ठीक है, मे बी यू आर नॉट मेड फॉर दैट, राइट? देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दैट आई एम अनेबल टू डू. आई डू नॉट हैव द स्किल्स टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, और आई डू नॉट हैव द एप्टीट्यूड टू डू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. इट डज नॉट मीन दैट आई एम अ फेलियर इन एवरीथिंग. आई मे फाइंड अ वे, आई मे फाइंड अ फील्ड, आई मे फाइंड अ काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट आई कैन ब्लूम इन, आई कैन डू वेल इन. सो वो वही बात है कि इट्स ऑल अबाउट एक्सपेरिमेंटिंग एंड लर्निंग फ्रॉम योर मिस्टेक एंड फाइंडिंग द प्लेसेस वेयर यू कैन ऐड वैल्यू. सो वो बड़ा जरूरी है. और कोड गर्ल्स में हम उनको कोडिंग के अलावा इतनी सारी चीजें सिखा रहे होते हैं, एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप पढ़ा रहे हैं, सोलोप्रेन्योरशिप पढ़ा रहे हैं, वर्क प्लेस सेफ्टी पढ़ा रहे हैं, फाइनेंशियल लिटरेसी पढ़ा रहे हैं. उसका रीजन यही है कि वी आर ट्राइंग टू मेक देम थिंक सो दैट दे कैन मेक अ डिसीजन एंड डिसाइड फॉर देमसेल्व्स एंड काइंड ऑफ टेक लाइफ इन अ मोर प्लेफुल वे रादर देन जस्ट यू नो वॉकिंग ऑन अ पाथ दैट वॉज ऑलरेडी लेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम.
ओके, वेरी गुड. देखो मेरी ऑडियंस को ये तो समझ आ गया व्हाई वी आर फ्रेंड्स एंड व्हाई आई वांटेड टू इनवाइट यू गाइस. इतना सारा विजडम बैठा हुआ है, ठीक है. अच्छा, बाय द वे, सो मेरा जो लास्ट फाइनल क्वेश्चन होता है अबाउट लीविंग अ मैसेज बिहाइंड, ज़ीशान आल्सो वांट्स दैट, राइट? सो ही इज सेइंग इफ यू कैन गिव सम गुड एडवाइस फॉर आई गेस लाइफ गोल्स एज योर एक्सपीरियंस. आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट द मैसेज इज. सो यस, हूएवर वांट्स टू गो फर्स्ट. शमीम, डू यू वांट टू गो फर्स्ट?
तो नॉर्मली जो जब इस तरह का सवाल आता है तो यूजुअली वी कम बैक विद समथिंग दैट वी लर्न रिसेंटली. तो वेरी रिसेंटली आई वाज शेयर्ड ए यूट्यूब वीडियो टेडेक्स पाकिस्तान से, साद हामिद ने मुझे शेयर की थी. उसमें मैंने एक चीज बहुत एंड वी नो अबाउट इट, वी जस्ट डोंट यू नो लुक एट इट फ्रॉम दैट एंगल और फ्रॉम दैट पर्सपेक्टिव. उसमें एक बड़ी मजे की चीज जो मैंने पढ़ी एंड दैट आई वांटेड टू लीव एवरीवन लीव विद एवरीवन टुडे इज वी नीड टू टेल अवर वुमेन दैट देयर स्ट्रेंथ इज नॉट मेजर्ड बाय द लेवल ऑफ कॉम्प्रोमाइज. जैसे फायदा ने कहा ना कि हम वी कम वेरी टफ ऑन आवरसेल्व्स जब हम कोई मिस्टेक करते हैं, बिकॉज वो लड़की पे मार्क नहीं हो सकता. तो वो जो है शी नीड्स टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट हर स्ट्रेंथ शुड नॉट बी मेजर्ड बाय द लेवल ऑफ कॉम्प्रोमाइज दैट शी डज फॉर हरसेल्फ और फॉर हर फैमिली. And we need to tell our men that their strength is not measured by how much they can box in their emotions. Now this going back to the fact that मर्द से कहा था कि जी मर्द ने रोना नहीं है, कभी रोना नहीं है, और औरत रोती है पर मर्द कभी नहीं रोता. So they basically box in their emotions. So even having friends around to share things with, they are not able to do that. ये ख़वातीन का strength होता है कि चूंकि आप emotionally sane होते हैं तो आप कहीं गलती करते हैं, यू यू फील फुल, यू वांट टू एम्प्टी योरसेल्फ. मेन विल नेवर डू दैट. सो दे बॉक्स इन द इमोशंस. द लॉट ऑफ द वे दे द लॉट ऑफ द टाइम्स दे कम आउट द वे दैट दे डू इज बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव अ चैनल टू बेसिकली गेट द इमोशंस आउट. सो आई थिंक आई वांट टू लीव विद दैट मैसेज. एंड देन ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट आई हैव लर्न्ड लेसन लर्न्ड इन लाइफ विद एक्सपीरियंस इज दैट मैंने देखा है कि इंसान कभी भी अच्छा या बुरा नहीं होता, हालात अच्छे या बुरे होते हैं. ये मैंने किसी फिल्म में सुना था. बेनिफिट ऑफ डाउट, यू डोंट नो द काइंड ऑफ डे दैट दे हैव हैड, राइट? सो यू नीड टू गिव देम द बेनिफिट ऑफ डाउट एंड गेट द गुड आउट ऑफ दैट कॉन्वर्सेशन एंड लीव द बैड असाइड. नॉट दैट बिकम अ फूल आउट ऑफ इट, बट लीव इट असाइड. तो आपका नुकसान भी ना हो, उनका भी ना हो, एंड देन जस्ट मूव ऑन. So that's I think professional attitude. Yeah.
Thank you, Shamim. Okay, Faiza, more wisdom.
I think the only thing that I've learned so far is in life, I would say that is your ability to have empathy for other people, what Shamim said. And it's extremely important, but at the same time, the kindness that you show to other people, you also need to show it to yourself. So do not be, so again, hold yourself accountable for things that you have done, but at the same time, do not show cruelty towards yourself. And nothing is permanent. Whatever is happening, things will change, situations will change, everything will change. So whatever is happening, we kept on having this discussion in the classroom today about things not being permanent. And I think that's the biggest lesson that life can give you, is that it's not permanent, and whatever, you have a short time. So make sure that it's worth your while, in the sense that you can do the things that you want to do. Yeah.
So thank you, ladies. Thank you very, very much for joining us. Bahut zyada achhe achhe messages aap dono ne diye, and I think I agree completely with you. Nothing is constant except the fact that nothing is constant, right? That's the only constant thing that you have in life. And what you said, you know, both of you, right? So be kind. So I think kabhi kabhi jo Disney movies hoti hai na, I know, while at the same time they perpetrate a lot of different images of women not so strong, oh prince aayega bachayega, all of that aside, I think Cinderella ka jo favorite message tha na, that was in the end when her mom keeps, or right at the beginning, her mom keeps saying be courageous and be kind. I think that's really the bottom line, right? Ki try to be kind to yourself, to other people, try to understand people, let things go, it's okay, you only live once, right? Kitne arse tak grudges deke baithe rahenge, and just keep moving and keep growing. So thank you very, very much. And you guys know this already, but just for the audience as well. Look, I think, okay, Zeeshan keh rahe, I got my point. Okay, thank you, Zeeshan. Acha, so what was I going? Yes, what I was going to say to you both is, you know, thank you so much for creating that base, right? So now when we think, just say Epiphany, ab koshish kar rahe gaming ki side mein, cheezein karne ki, right? Aur hum ye developers game jam kar rahe hain. So you guys are the first persons that I turn to. And other people like you, right? So Sadaf is doing TechKaro, and the ones who've been building up Google Developers Group, etc. So reaching out to them, our life is easier because we know, okay, the base is there, the community is there. If we want to pull certain people and train them further in a particular direction, we have the base that's ready. So, you know, keep doing what you guys are doing. You have all of my support, and thank you once again.
Thank you so much for having us. It's a pleasure.
Thank you so much. It's
a pleasure. Sorry, I made a mistake. I was trying to remove them. Okay, all right. So before I head out, thank you so much for being patient. I'm really sorry about being late today, but I'm a little scatterbrained, Arch. So what I did want to mention, so this coming week, inshallah, we are announcing officially the Developers Game Jam that we are doing from the 27th till the 29th of November. We're on a mission. We're on a mission to try and bring as many women, as many young people, both men and women, actually, into the gaming world. More stress on women. Why? Because women are dismally, the numbers for women is dismally low in the gaming industry. So in the Developers Game Jam, we're looking for seasoned developers as well as inexperienced developers jinko shauk ho raha hai gaming seekhne ka, game development seekhne ka. So this coming week, just, you know, keep watching this space, LinkedIn hamara jo page hai, Facebook ka page, etc. We will be announcing over there. The objective, I've told you, it's going to be a 60-hour long game jam. And you know, lots of interesting workshops hum embed kar rahe hain, because of course new developers bhi hain, aspiring developers as well as experienced developers. So it's going to be a mix for everything. Thank you so much for showing the love, and thanks for listening. I think it's you know, agar aapne miss bhi kiya hai, please go ahead and watch the full thing towards the end. Is I think a lot of true nuggets of information and wisdom have come through. So thanks so much for watching, and khuda hafiz, have a great weekend.